We have a guest. It's our honor to have this guest here. That you know very well through Ummah TV. Muhammad Shafiq. I am Muhammad Shafiq, close up of Ummah TV.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. I was here to listen to the Honorable Sheikh. I just want to share two things really with you. I had the honor of sitting with Sheikh Nazim when I was a student, about 12, 13. He used to go every Ramadan to Peckham and stay there for a few days and do zikr. So it's honorable honor to be here. And inshallah al-Aziz, the interview we did with the Sheikh yesterday will be shown very soon on my channel, a week on Saturday, inshallah. It was a great interview. And Sheikh answered all the questions I asked and many more as well. So Allah Ta'ala preserve the Sheikh. Allah Ta'ala give him a long life. And may we, Ahl Sunnah wal Jamaat, we are lacking for our youth today examples. Real examples of how to live our lives according to the Sunnah. And the Sheikh and Sheikh Nazim are excellent examples for our youth today. So we pray that Allah gives them a long life and gives them a success in their work. Jazakallahu khair. Salaamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. By the way, I'm Muhammad Shafiq from Ummah channel. Okay. Sheikh wants me to act up what I say in my beginning of my piece. Hello and welcome to Close Up. I'm Muhammad Shafiq.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I don't know what to say really because Muhammad Shafiq is here, so. But I will try to do my best. We are in Sha'ban, the month of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It's okay. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, alayhi afdalu salatu wasallam, sallu ala nabi. Sallu ala nabi. Not yet. Sallu ala nabi. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wassalatu wassalamu ala ashrafil mursaleen. سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أيها الحفل الكريم الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي جعلنا من أمة الحبيب المصطفى عليه أفضل الصلاة والسلام وشرفنا بأن نكون على أعتابه عليه أفضل الصلاة والتسليم فيا سيدي يا رسول الله يا حبيب الله جميعا نخاطبك من هذا المكان أن تنظر علينا بنظر الإحسان وأن تنظر علينا بنظر محبتك يا رسول الله وأن تنظر علينا بنظر القرآن وأن تنظر علينا بنظر الإيمان نرجو يا سيدي يا رسول الله أن تجعلنا دائما على أعتابك وعلى أبوابك ومعك في الدنيا وفي الآخرة O believers, we are nothing. Yesterday, I was being asked a question, which till today I am thinking about it. And I'm saying, oh, astaghfirullah al-azim wa atubu ilayh. Astaghfirullah al-azim wa atubu ilayh. أستغفر الله العظيم وأتوب إليه. The question was, which awakened me, because I was sleeping. Not real sleeping, but I was not paying attention. I was being asked that, are you proud of your work that you have done all these years? From conferences to conferences, standing up for Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah and so on. That I was stunned. is a nice question, is a right question, and it awakened me. Why it awakened me? Because Allah said in Holy Quran, وَلَا تُزَكُّوا أَنفُسَكُمْ. Don't ever try to praise your ego. Means, وَقَدِمْنَا إِلَى مَا عَمِلُوا فَجَعَلْنَاهُ هَبَاءً مَنْثُورًا. We come to what they have done, we don't care, king, or president, or minister, or normal person, if he is coming to us with his ego, we throw all his amal in his face. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُبْحِبُّ الْمُتَكَبِّرِينَ. Allah doesn't like those who are arrogant and proud of themselves. So it awakened me that, oh, people look at you that you did something, but you don't know that if I throw it in your face in the day of judgment, you go to hellfire. Don't try to praise your ego. Don't try to praise yourself. Always think that our amal might not be accepted. Our amal might not be liked because it is mixed and blended with our desires, with our ego. But with all that, look, Allah's mercy. This is a piece of what you call it in English, bouquet of flower. It's from different colors. You look at it, you feel happy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam a nice bouquet of flower. Not this flower, this, it attracts us. But Allah gave him heavenly one. Gave him one that never ends. Always alive. This might dry in 2 days or 3 days if it is not plastic. If it is plastic, it doesn't worth anything. If it is not plastic, it works for 2-3 days and then you throw it. But what Allah gave to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam never ends. What Allah gave to Prophet, O Muslims, He gave him two things, which we speak about. One of them, He gave him a bouquet of flower, heavenly one. When He ordered angels to make salawat on Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when He said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ. Allah and His angels are praising and ascending salawat on Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That will never end. It will continue. There is no end. Always angels are under the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make salawat on Prophet Sayyidina Muhammad alayhi afdal salatu wasalam. And their salawat is not like our salawat. Their salawat is a different salawat. This book, for example, Dalail, angels, Dalail Khairat, that Muslims to recite, to read, but angels, Allah gave them a heavenly salawat that they have to make on Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator. He created angels, He is creating angels, and He will be continuing creating angels. Never ends. Creation never ends. Creations of angels never ends. No beginning, no end. No one knows their beginning, no one knows their end. In Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knowledge. Ordering all of them to making salawat on Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And their salawat, from one angel to another angel, is a different salawat. How much you hired him to say that? Their salawat is not like our salawat. Every angel, like every flower of these flowers, different. Different in color, different in what is this? Butter. These are two same, but they are not the same. But they are the same. But there must be something different. Allah will not create two things together similar. This one making salawat, this one making salawat. وَإِن مِّن شَيْءٍ إِلَّا يُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِهِ وَلَكِنْ لَا تَفْقَهُونَ تَسْبِيحَهُمْ. Everything praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and angels are praising Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they never stops. We think they are the same, but they are not the same. They have different, if you count how many, what's that? Pattern, might be this one has 10, this one has 11. They are different. So everything, every angel is his salawat different from the other angel. And every angel salawat, when he say it one time, he doesn't repeat it second time. Must be different. This is azamatullah. Allah greatness, you cannot limit it. You cannot say all angels are doing the same salawat. That is not azama lil nabi wala azama lillah azza wa jal. Azamatul nabi as a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cannot be limited. Wa azamatullah as khaliq al khaliq cannot be limited. According to Allah's azama, angels are praising Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And their salawat are given to whom? To Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So this one gift to Prophet. This one gift that Allah gave to his Prophet, which never ends. Second gift, there are many gifts, but second gift, if we can say that, كنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس تأمرون بالمعروف وتنهون عن المنكر. Allah gave Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the best ummah, the ummah that is successful dunya and akhirah. كنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس. You were the best ummah that has been sent to humanity. You are not in my eyes, in Allah's eyes. I don't give my Prophet the worst ummah. I don't give to my Prophet except the best. He gave him the best. You are the best in the eyes of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the best has to do the best. What is the best? In this life, in order to prepare for the other life, there is one best. As Allah ordered angels to make salawat, Allah ordered us, يَا أَلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ. You want to be the best? Of course you are the best. But to be continuously, daily, the best, make salawat on Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. من صلى عليه صلى الله عليه من صلى علي مرة صلى الله عليه بها عشرة. Allah, you make one salawat, Allah make 10 salawat for you. Our salawat is cheap. Sorry to say that. But Allah salawat on us, precious. So to attract Allah salawat, He said, make one salawat on my beloved one, you'll attract my 10 salawat to you. So say salat ala al-Nabi, Allahumma salli ala al-Nabi. Sallu alayhi. In Indonesia, when I say sallu alayhi, you hear the whole is shaking. Don't be sleepy. Sallu alayhi. Allahu Akbar. People are sending messages on the internet, on the Facebook, on Twitter, saying why they are sleeping when you are giving a lecture. Sometimes we hear takbir.
Allahu Akbar.
Nare takbir.
Allahu Akbar.
Nare risala.
Ya Rasulullah.
Sallu ala al-Nabi.
Allahu
Akbar. Ah, it's better. Don't be sleepy. We have accountants counting, ya Allah, quickly. Angels are counting. Oh, these, their voices are sleepy, but they sing salawat. Never mind, we write for them 10 salawat back. But they are generous with us. If you want to be generous and loving to Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sallu alayhi. Allahumma salli ala al-Nabi. We are hearing, do you like to have a nice house? Huh? Yes or no?
Yes.
All of us, we like to have a nice house. And then after some years, we say, let us renovate the house and make it bigger. Then we go ahead and make it bigger. Then another time, you still like to do it bigger, but you don't have enough, but you save some and then you do it bigger and bigger. Madinatul Munawwara wa Makkatul Mukarrama. Masjid al-Nabawi wa Masjid al-Makki. Every now and then, they make it bigger, tawsi'a, tawsi'atul haramain, to increase the size. And Allah fills it. Now you don't find even they make it as big as whole Mecca, you will not find place to pray. It's Allah's greatness. They make Masjid al-Nabawi as bigger as should be and make it more bigger and still you cannot find a place to pray. You want to make your house big enough that you don't find a place to stand for your guest in it? Yes?
Yes.
Salawat ala al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As much as you do salawat, as much Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will increase your palace in paradise. To bring inside it as much as you like of guests. Don't think that the salawat are cheap. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves His Prophet. Just now, they recited part of Al-Burda Sharifa. How much love Al-Busairi was showing. And I will tell a story that may Allah bless his soul, our grand sheikh. He said that one time Sayyidina Al-Busairi, but before to come to Sayyidina Al-Busairi, he said there was one wali, big wali, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, sincere servants. taking his student a trip because they like to do that siyaha. This is the ways of prophets to go around, like what you call siyaha in English. Journey, spiritual journeys. They go and the student, they live with them, they speak with them, they learn from them, whatever they are teaching. And they were going by the Nile River. And they reach a place at night, they want to camp and sleep there for morning by the river, for morning to go back for their journey. One place they camp, and morning time, Fajr time, before 1 hour, they wake up and they went to the Nile to take wudu. As soon as they went to put their hands, the water was boiling. Water boiling. Why they are water boiling? They walked a little bit, it's boiling. They want to pray Fajr, they cannot pray Fajr. Then the Sheikh wake up and ask for water. They said, "Ya Sayyidi, the water is boiling. We cannot take it. It's more than normal temperature. It is more than boiling temperature." He said, "Let us make tayammum and we pray." They prayed, they did their awrad, and the Sheikh said, "Let us go up the river, the Nile River, to see where it began to boil, why it's boiling." And they went up and they found one man sitting on a stone and putting his feet in the Nile River and reciting. As they approaching, he was reciting Al-Burda Sharifa. He was not reciting only, he was, I don't want to say composing, but he was Muhammad al-Busairi, who through the imla'at, through the dictation or the inspiration in his heart from Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was praising Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. From his love to Prophet, the water was boiling. And he said, "Ya Imam, can you take your feet out? فمبلغ العلم فيه أنه بشر وأنه خير خلق الله كلهم." He said, he's telling the Sheikh with the student, after he took his feet, out of love, out of ashq, out of, doesn't think anything about dunya. He's only his dunya and his akhirah, his food, his water, is Muhammadur Rasulullah. He doesn't need to eat. Allah will send his rizq. But have real love. Not only making the qasida and that's it, which is alhamdulillah, is very good. But we need to live with it. We need to learn about it. I read many different books from different authors on the explanation, spiritual explanation of Qasidatul Burda, that has lot of ma'ani, lot of understanding. One of them is فَمَبْلَغُ الْعِلْمِ فِيهِ أَنَّهُ بَشَرٌ. The highest knowledge that we as human being understand Prophet is, he is a human being. We say al-insanul kamil, the perfect human being. That is the highest that we know. That is the highest that anyone can understand. فَمَبْلَغُ الْعِلْمِ, the end of knowledge about him, that he is a human being. And he's saying, I was stuck on that first half of the verse. I am composing the burda and inspired by Prophet and writing, and it's coming to me. فَمَبْلَغُ الْعِلْمِ فِيهِ أَنَّهُ بَشَرٌ وَمَبْلَغُ الْعِلْمِ فِيهِ أَنَّهُ بَشَرٌ. I was not able to continue the second part of the verse. And at that moment, I saw the Prophet appearing in front of me. And he added for me up the verse. وَأَنَّهُ خَيْرُ خَلْقِ اللَّهِ كُلِّهِمِ. I was unable to connect these two. I was saying only فَمَبْلَغُ الْعِلْمِ فِيهِ أَنَّهُ بَشَرٌ فَمَبْلَغُ الْعِلْمِ فِيهِ. And the continuation doesn't come until Prophet appeared to me and said, Ya Busayr, Ya Imam, add وَأَنَّهُ خَيْرُ خَلْقِ اللَّهِ كُلِّهِمِ. And he is for sure the best of creation. خَيْرُ خَلْقِ اللَّهِ كُلِّهِمِ. He is the best creation that Allah created, not only from human beings, from anything that been created, this universe, angels, jinn, mu'min, Muslims, non-Muslims, animals, living, non-living, mountains, stars, galaxies, everything, he is better than all of them. Allahu Akbar. How much they paid you? Oh Muslims, believers, when that question was posed to me, that are you proud of what you are achieving? What am I achieving? Look, Imam Muhammad al-Busairi, he has achieved to see Prophet in front of him in a daytime, not in a dream, appearing and saying, yes, ya Imam, continue, وَأَنَّهُ خَيْرُ خَلْقِ اللَّهِ كُلِّهِمِ. And he really, verily, the best of the creation. We are what we are. We are achieving what to be proud of? We are achieving nothing. We are like ants. Everyone think he is a universe by himself. No. We want Prophet to be proud from us. Not we proud of our achievement. Our achievement, as I said, Allah said in Holy Quran, we come to their what they have done and we throw it in their faces. وَقَدِمْنَا إِلَى مَا عَمِلُوا فَجَعَلْنَاهُ هَبَاءً مَنْثُورًا. هَبَاءً مَنْثُورًا means dust in the air. We come to what they have done, we throw it and become nothing in this universe. It's empty, finish. You are now nothing on you, coming to Allah's presence, and Allah wants to check you, what you want to say. I mentioned yesterday one thing, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, first, he will judge three people. And this is, we have to put it in our mind as youth living in this country and as youth living in every country in order to understand Islam. Not what they have tell you always it is correct. It is from their understanding, from their own perspective. And I will give one example. Allah will come, and this is in Sahih Muslim. And no one can say, no, it is incorrect. It's a Sahih Hadith mentioned by a Salafi author, student of Ibn Taymiyyah, Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyyah, in his book, Ad-Dawa'u al-Shafi. I'm repeating it. Yesterday, I didn't mention it in the event, like this event in night, it was before. The first Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will judge, there are three. Giving to teach, for teaching us. Be careful. Who is the best person after Prophet and Sahaba and Imams? Who are these best ones that the Allah will give them a high rank in Akhirah? Who are they? Who? After Awliya Allah. Shuhada. Allah will call one shaheed. Not all of shuhada are, all of them are different levels. He called one. He came to Allah's presence and Allah showed him. He says, these are my favors that I am giving to you, what you did to get them. What you deserve. What kind of amal you did for me that you deserve my favors, these ones that I am going to give to you. Give me an answer. You, what you did for me. And that first one was a martyr. He said, Ya Rabbi, I am a shaheed. He said, shaheed, what you did? I killed myself for your sake. That's yes, correct? In holy war. But what you did to me, you didn't do that to me. He said, Ya Rabbi, I did it for your greatness, for your sake. I killed for your sake, I became shaheed. He said, no, you are lying. The one that we think he is shaheed, Allah is saying to him, you are lying. Oh, angels of hellfire, come take, throw him in fire. Ya Rabbi, what I did? You did not do it for me. You did it for your ego to say to people, look, this man is courageous. To say, to have people speak about you, to make history, to write your name. You didn't do it for me. You did it for your arrogance and your tyranny in your arrogance, in yourself. Like today, people, they go and explode themselves and kill innocent people. These are shaheed. These are going to be asked by Allah, according to that hadith of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that is mentioned by the student of Ibn Taymiyyah. Then Allah sent after someone else. He looked and he called a rich man. Very rich one. And he said to him, oh my servant, I am offering these favors to the one that is generous. What you did for me to deserve these favors? He said, I was generous, Ya Rabbi. I was building schools, making mosques, making this, making that. He said, you are lying. You did that for your reputation. You didn't do it for me. You did it for yourself. Oh angels, take him to hellfire. Then he called the third one. And he asked him, what you did for me? And that third one will be alim, the alim, scholar. What you did for me to deserve these favors? Ya Rabbi, I teach people. I made them to memorize this, memorize that, teach them fuqh. Putting doctor near your name. Putting professor near your name. You are running after doctor so and so. When you put a book, you say doctor so and so. Or when you do something, you say I am professor so and so. If they give you to sit on the chair, you get angry, you don't come to the conference, you run away. So you didn't do it for me. You taught people, and your heart is ignorant. And that's why Prophet ﷺ said, أَخْوَفُ مَا أَخَافُ عَلَىٰ أُمَّتِي عَالِمٌ عَلِيمٌ بِاللِّسَانِ جَهُولٌ بِالْقَلْبِ. I fear most for my ummah, عَالِم, عَلِيمٌ بِاللِّسَانِ, knows how to talk, but he's ignorant in his heart. Oh, mu'min, with all this, that we make you a little bit afraid, we are still the bouquet of flowers to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the day of judgment, Allah give him intercession. He immediately makes sajda between Allah's hands and say, Ya Rabbi. As soon as he say, Ya Rabbi, it's a hadith in Adab al-Mufrad in al-Bukhari. Allah open, he say, Prophet, Allah open to my heart du'as that he never opened before. I begin my heart like a running fountain of du'as coming from my tongue that I never understood it before or it came to my heart before to recite it. So what kind of du'a? Is the du'a that we read daily in books and means something heavenly, but still in Arabic, because the language of paradise is Arabic. Not Pakistani, not Urdu. But the Pakistanis are the best. Because they are devoted to Prophet love. I went everywhere. I saw Pakistanis and subcontinent. They are so in love to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Every day, Qasida, morning, evening, after every prayer, after every food, after every work, they go for Qasida. Prophet went into in sajda and he makes dua that never been opened before, and Allah say to him, Ya Muhammad, irfa ra'sak sal tu'ata. Raise your head, ask, I will give you. He say, Ya Rabbi, I don't want anything else. Not for me, I don't want anything for me, I want for them. He say, take one third to paradise. And Prophet take you to paradise. Inshallah, take all of us. To paradise, no question, no account. Look, mashallah, beautiful, beautiful dresses, beautiful beards. All of you, mashallah, children, young ones, older ones. Look at these young ones. And we say Islam is not strong. Islam, mashallah, can give so much that can benefit the whole universe. But we need good scholars, good peers, good awliyaullah. Follow the sunnah of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This whole earth will become, most of the laws of the world came from Holy Quran and from Hadith of Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Prophet sent by Allah's order one third of the ummah to paradise. No account. Is he satisfied? No. He go for another sajda. And Allah, he say, Allah opened du'as for me that he didn't open before. Not in the first time, not before. And I ask, and Allah say, raise your head, I ask and I give you. He say, Ya Rabbi Ummati. He say, okay, take half of the rest. Then he said, I go a third time. And make sajda. And ask, Ya Rabbi, with dua that Allah opened to me, that I didn't open in the second time or the first time. And I asked him until he say, raise your head, I will give you. He said, my ummah. And Allah give him the rest. Except one. He sent the rest, all the ummah enter paradise without, except one. And that one is shaking. Means one that no one can count his bad amal. Because to Allah to keep him means he sent everyone to paradise except that one, means he is the worst one. And Allah looks at him and he say, oh my servant, and this hadith of Prophet, oh my servant, who put that mercy in the heart of Prophet, of my Prophet, is me. And my mercy encompass you, go with them to paradise. I forgive you.
Allah.
Marhaba, marhaba. Marhaba, marhaba. Marhaba, marhaba. Marhaba, marhaba. Jive, jive. Marshad 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 jive. Nare takbir. Marshad Jeeva, 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 Marshad Jeeva. MashaAllah, MashaAllah, MashaAllah. People of paradise. Amen. InshaAllah, dunya and akhirah. As we said yesterday, I would end with that. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. وَإِذَا خَاطَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا. When ignorant people come to you, don't answer them. Say peace on you and on us. We don't want to go into a dispute or disagreement. Imam Shafi'i used to, you know Imam Shafi'i, one of the great imam, the third one. Every day, going to Fajr prayer, he passed by the house of Nafisatul Tahira, one of the grandchildren of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. She is buried in her home in Egypt, Cairo. He passed by her and knocked at her door with some of his students, and before going to pray Fajr, like Qiyamul Layl, before Fajr 2 hours. And he entered her house by her permission with some of his students, and she used to teach them Tafsir al-Quran. Look, I don't understand why some scholars makes to look that women are lower than men. She was teaching Sayyidina al-Imam al-Shafi'i, the third imam of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah. And he used to say that This is every day, going to his house, to the masjid to pray in the Fajr time. And when he comes inside, where she used to sit, she in her room, she made a grave. And she sit in the grave, worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when she is having time. And the other time, taking care of the family. And she say, and they ask her, why you have a grave in your room? She said, because I want to be buried there. So whatever I read, the tajalli, Allah sent reward to that holy, to that place, make it a place of heaven, inshallah. So Imam Shafi'i was so astonished that there are still, he says, in Egypt, people like that. Look, like 1,000 years ago, how much corruption was there. Like today, corruption. And you know, Imam Shafi'i, he was coming from Iraq, Baghdad. He put his school of thought, he wrote it all in Baghdad. When he came to Egypt, he changed it. When he saw the corruption and he saw the sins and bad things going on, he became more strict and he changed his whole mazhab into a new way of understanding according to the environment he was living in that time in Egypt. So that's why he has two mazhab, one in Baghdad, one in Egypt. How many mazhab we have to change today in order to be on the right way, but full of corruption? Today, wherever you walk, you face a sin, man or woman, no? Men or women, in the schools, in the restaurants, in the universities, in the hospitals, in the street, everywhere you face sins. So what a school of thought we have to follow? Allah said, قُلْ يَا مُحَمَّدُ, say to them, إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهِ. If you really love Allah, follow Muhammad. How to follow? They asked me, in Singapore, I have the conference, and the title of my speech is GPS for Future Life. Charting the spiritual destination. Charting the spiritual destination. So what's GPS? Yes, of course, there is a GPS in our heart, a navigation system, telling you what is right, what is wrong. Allah said, فَأَلْهَمَهَا فُجُورَهَا وَتَقْوَاهَا. Allah inspired the self, what is good, what is wrong. There is a GPS. And the GPS is قَدْ جَاءَكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ نُورٌ. Is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He is the guide. He is a nur. In tafsir, Allahu nuru samawati wal ard, مَثَلُ نُورِهِ. That part, مَثَلُ نُورِهِ. Allah is the light of heaven and earth. The example of his nur, that nur, is Muhammad, is guidance. If there is no electricity here, you don't see anything. When the light comes, you see everything. So through Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you see everything. Ya Rasulallah. Ya Rasulallah. MashaAllah, MashaAllah. I like this one. This one and this one. Jive, jive. Thank you.
Hak Nazim, Ya Nazim. مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كله مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كله يا أكرم الخلق ما لي من ألوذ به سواك عند حلول الحديث العام مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبد على حبيبك خير الخلق كله الحمد لله والشكر لله الحمد لله والشكر لله الذي هدانا سلطان الأولياء محمد ناظم أعلى الله درجاته محمد ناظم أعلى الله درجاته محمد ناظم حق رحمة من السماء محمد ناظم رحمة من السماء لك النبي جد لك علي جد لك الحسن جد لك الحسين جد وابن الصبطين صبت وابن الصبطين صبت وابن الصبطين صبت وابن الصبطين صبت يحمينا من الأعداء الحمد لله والشكر لله الحمد لله والشكر لله الذي هدانا سلطان الأولياء محمد ناظم أعلى الله درجاته محمد ناظم ونفعنا ببركاته محمد ناظم رحمة من السماء محمد ناظم رحمة من السماء بكم الأرض تسقى بكم السائل يعطى بكم العائل يغنى بكم من ضل يهدى من عارفكم لا يشقى من عارفكم لا يشقى من عارفكم لا يشقى من عارفكم لا يشقى يسلم من كل شقاء الحمد لله والشكر لله الحمد لله والشكر لله الذي هدانا سلطان الأولياء أعلى الله درجات ومحمد ناظم ونفعنا ببركاته محمد ناظم رحمة من السماء محمد ناظم رحمة من السماء We love you, we love you, we love you so much We love you, what else can we say? We love you, we love you, we love you so much We love you, what else can we say? May Allah give you long life, health and happiness. May Allah give you long life, health and happiness. Sheikh, our master, our teacher, our guiding light, our love for you is great. You saved us from the darkest night into the brightest day. Our heaven is to be with you no matter where you stay. Please don't throw us away. We love you, we love you, we love you so much. We love you, what else can we say? We love you, we love you, we love you so much. We love you, what else can we say? We love you, we love you, we love you so much. We love you, what else can we say? We love you, we love you, we love you so much. We love you, what else can we say? Sallu ala Muhammad.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين اللهم بجاه حبيبك المصطفى ورسولك المرتضى وبجاه أوليائك الكرام وبجاه سيد الشيخ محمد ناظم الحقاني أن لا تدع لنا في مجلسنا هذا ذنبا إلا غفرته ولا دينا إلا قضيته ولا مريضا إلا شفيته ولا حاجة من حوائج الدنيا إلا يسرتها يا رب العالمين اللهم يسر أمورنا وفرج كروبنا يا سيدي يا مولانا الشيخ ناظم We are putting into your hands the problem of our two brothers They are innocent from what they have accused them with We are asking you to petition them in front of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in order that they will be released immediately without any case because they didn't do anything wrong they didn't do something that we heard we don't believe it because we know these people may Allah give them release and may Allah make the judges they are good judges to look into the situation in their hearts and in their mind and to give the best judge they can in order to release these two people for the sake of Allah, for the sake of Prophet, for the sake of Awliya, for the sake of everyone that is pious, inshallah. Wa min Allahi tawfiq bi hurmati al-Fatiha. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. These two books are very important if you get them from the back. One on salawat on Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I think many of you know about it. It takes all, anything of like magic and problem, marital problem. And this book is a series of very nice series of different lectures. Inshallah, they are outside in the hall.
Some brothers and sisters collecting funds for Syria.
What?
Some brothers and sisters collecting funds for Syria.
Okay. There are some buckets that will be passed. Some people, they are standing at the doors collecting for money for human aid, inshallah, in Syria for only human aid, nothing else. And they go themselves to deliver it. Try your best to give as much as you can to them, and inshallah, you'll be rewarded, they will be rewarded. There is this cassette, this CD, for our boss, our Elvis Presley, Michael Jackson of God, of God. If anyone wants to get this outside, there is also a Zahra ensemble. It's a CD of seven girls. The age is 16 to 18. On Qasidas of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and it is very good for people, especially the girls, to buy and to get one. If you don't have money to buy, take it free. And if they say anything to you, say Sheikh said. And don't worry about it. But this one, I cannot speak on his behalf, because on the other one, the ladies, one of them is my daughter, so I can manage it. But this one, Ali Sayyid, I cannot say it, he will kill me outside. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Burshe Jive. Brothers and sisters, before you go, there's on the ladies, please go from this side, and inshallah, food will be served. It's takeout box. And for the brothers this way, through the entrance, the brothers are waiting there. Inshallah, you can take the food home and inshallah, have it. Thank you.